Hello my friends! As you already know, here at BION Terrarium Center we try to do our best to share our experience and any useful info to help other breeders in our common hobby. In the following video we will show you how to define sex of different species of leaf-tailed geckos since the very moment of hatching. To tell sex of most of Uroplatus species you will have to wait 1, 2, or probably 3 years until males will show clear signs of hemipenal bulges. But with some species you can tell whether you have a male or a female just during the first seconds as soon as you find the baby hatched in your incubation box. Please keep in mind that none of these techniques will give you 100% confidence about the sex of your babies, but you will be 90-95% sure that you have a male or a female, and therefore you will be able to plan your sales, to plan your further breeding projects. I hope that you will enjoy the video. When it comes to Uroplatus fantasticus, satanic leaf-tailed geckos, in most cases sex can be identified immediately after hatching. Males will typically have well-seen serrated tails with spikes at its base and clear white tear-like spot under each eye. Females will have smooth edges of the tail and the tear-like white drop underneath the eye is usually absent or faded or with another coloration. Of course, some cases are quite complicated and it is better to wait until sexual maturity to say whether you have a male or a female. The same approach is used for sex in Uroplatus ebenaui or spearpoint leaf-tailed gecko. Even with considerably smaller tails, they will be serrated in males and smooth in females. Situation with the white tear-like spots under the eyes is the same. In Uroplatus giganteus, sexing is more difficult. From our experience, confirmed by many other breeders, the babies that have mossy dark green coloration with no obvious geometric pattern are females. Brown or gray babies, especially with well-seen diamond-like pattern on the back, will become males. Things become worse as babies grow, as they change coloration, and the next time you will be able to tell their sex will be in 2 or 3 years due to presence of hemipenal bulges. Night is the best time for sexing of Uroplatus lineatus, as at this time they intensify their coloration. But the key points can be seen at daytime as well. Females will have lines along all the body from head to their tail base, while males don't have them. Their lining is rather pure or completely replaced by rows of spots and dots. If we talk about Uroplatus sicora or Uroplatus henkeli, there is very few cases when you can be sure that you have a female or a male. Most of such cases are connected with the animals of so-called piebald morph, when they have white stripes on the neck, back and some parts of the tail. Most of such animals are females. I hope that you enjoyed the video. If you have any other experience, ideas or approaches in sexing Uroplatus babies, please write it down in the comment section. And follow us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and stay safe!